gold at the 1936 Olympics. Bobby Charlton and the lads making it 3-0 against the Germans in the 1966 World Cup. And now, Tim Henman, you know, he did well at Wimbledon or whatever. But there's one more important sport in the picture that's burned into our collective consciousnesses. We go live to Darren Yend, squad leader. Could you tell me your feelings on winning Warzone?
It came to me and my team as a bit of a shock, to be honest with you. So much so, we didn't even know we won it. you know, that's the kind of team that we are. We play, you know, we play to the whistle. You know, we don't look at the numbers. We don't look how many teams are left. We just keep going until we win it, or more often than not, we die.
Or don't. See, you guys have been training for this for many weeks now. Did you ever believe it was possible?
You know, they say that belief is an important factor in your team's performance. So going back to your question, Mr. Banana.
Please call me Trevor.
Trevor, sorry. Going back to your earlier question, Trevor, is did I have belief within the squad? Not one bit. Not one bit, did I? You know, I think my initial reaction was, how the fuck did that happen?
Did you believe it was a mistake at first? Perhaps you were watching someone else play?
Yes. That's what I did think had happened. And as not only that, I mean, I believe we had an unfair advantage on that particular game, where the gas was actually on our side, as that took out a lot of the competition for us.
Indeed. My next question was going to be, when did you know for certain that you were going to win? Obviously, you didn't, so I'll skip that one.
I knew for certain that we was going to win when I was in the chopper.
In the chopper. How pissed do you think the other player is? The final three, and they're working hard. They've been playing a good match. And then some bastard just comes in and steals it blindly at the last second.
Livid for sure. He probably would have killed a damn sight more people than what we did. But he didn't factor in was strategy. So again, strategy.
And what exactly was the strategy you guys used on that fateful night?
Well, you see, what we like to do is we like to tool up, get a load of cash and armour. You know, and what we would do is we would just sit in a room and then go round the outside of the circle just picking people off. How we got into the... Well, my 2IC, that's second in command of this particular match, Oliver Cousins, had the nous to put up a deployable cover in the corner and hide behind that with a heartbeat sensor. And tactics worked it's worked out for us, and we very nearly pulled off a similar sort of victory, only for it to be torn away from us right at the last minute in another game.
Would you say that is by better players?
Pardon?
Would you say that's by better players?
No, I think on the day they were better for sure, but I think we got a little bit sloppy in the last thing, you know. And I said before, you know, we've got to play to the whistle, and see the match out. But we got a little bit careless, and when you get careless, you're going to be made to pay your mistakes, or your mistakes of
And what you got to say to those people who say, looking at the team's track record, this victory was supported by some sort of performance enhancing drugs?
Well, you know, yeah, I mean, is alcohol performance enhancing? I don't think it is. You know, yeah, you've got your critics out there that will say so. You know, and people look at our track record of underperforming, some might say. But, you know, look at Alex Ferguson's first season at Man United. Didn't win a thing. You know, so what are we saying, that they are now under performance enhancing drugs?
I mean, some of them are definitely on drugs, but yeah. And Darren, have you got any advice for people who are wishing to follow in your footsteps and become a Warzone winner?
Don't feel what me and, well, you know, since the new release of the new season was started, Call of Duty got a little bit, or Activision or Infinity Ward, whatever you want to call them, got a little bit jealous of our success that one time. And now you can't get away with doing what we do. Because I don't know for sure, but I think you appear on our other players' maps and they just come in and force you to fight.
Outrageous.
But I'm not a Frenchman, so I will stand there and die.
And have you got anyone that you want to give a special thanks to at this time?
You know, I think the thanks has to go to me, my second in command, like I said earlier on. You know, if it wasn't for him, the victory wouldn't be possible. I don't want to say that he carried the team because, you know, he didn't. I played a valuable part in drawing the enemy out.
They used up a lot of their bullets on your corpse. So.
Well, exactly. I'd like to thank my trainer, my gulag trainer, because it wasn't for him again. I wouldn't have got out of the gulag in the first instance. And I just want to thank, that I was born with opposable thumbs.
Good too. All right. Well, Darren, thank you very much for your time. I wish you many more victories.
You're very welcome. Competition's paying the price. I'm going to knock you out.